Welcome to Runcorn Station. In this training module, we'll be learning how to drive an LMS Stania Class 8F steam locomotive in BR Black livery. Stand on the platform and wait for your train to arrive. Today, you'll be taking over a freight service bound for Ditton. This class of locomotive was built between 1935 and 1946 and was designed as a freight version of the highly successful Black 5 locomotive. Climb up onto the footplate to begin. Let's prepare the locomotive for departure. The reverser determines the direction of travel and also how much power to apply. Move the reverser into the full forward position. This ensures you'll get the maximum power to get the train moving. As you pick up speed, you'll need to move it towards the centre. This locomotive has two types of brakes, steam and vacuum. Steam brakes will apply on just the locomotive. Vacuum brakes will apply on the rest of the train, so long as it is equipped with vacuum brakes. Use the combination brake to apply both types of brakes simultaneously. Vacuum brakes are released when there is a vacuum in the system. To apply braking force, air is added back in by the driver using the combination brake. To create a vacuum for the vacuum brake, we use the ejectors. The small ejector should be left open when the train is running. The large ejector can be used to more quickly increase the vacuum after coupling or heavy braking. Open the cylinder cocks to remove any water from cylinders after it has been left standing. Water in the cylinders can damage the locomotive if it doesn't compress like steam. The regulator acts like the throttle for the steam locomotive. It controls how much steam is delivered to the cylinders. Slowly open the regulator to apply power. Remember that power delivery is delayed in a steam locomotive. Applying too much power too early can cause a wheel slip. Now we're moving, we can open the regulator some more. We're starting to pick up speed. Move the reverser towards the mid gear. This reduces the amount of steam let into the cylinder, but saves energy. to stop in any position. Great work. Let's see how you did. Welcome to Ditton Junction. In this training module, we will learn how to read and react to semaphore signalling. In the top right are the signal and speed limit displays. These feature an indication of what is approaching and a countdown distance to when they will come into effect. Green indicates that you are clear to pass the signal. Yellow indicates that you can proceed, but with caution, as the next signal might be red or there could be a hazard. Red indicates that you should stop and should not pass this signal. Some of these displays can be hidden via the settings menu for a more challenging experience. Now let's take a look at some of the signals we'll see on this line. There are two principal classes of signals. Home and starter signals. These are mandatory and an approaching driver must stop if the signal displays a danger aspect. Distant signals. These are a warning. An approaching driver may pass the signal displaying a caution aspect but must be prepared to stop at the following signal. The signal in front of you is currently displaying a danger aspect. That means the line ahead is not clear and you must wait. The signal in front of you has now cleared. However, the next distant signal could display caution, meaning that the following signal will be displaying a danger aspect. Stay vigilant and keep an eye out for the next signal. Proceed when ready. Just look at the heads-up display if you're unsure what the next signal is. Great work. That's everything for this training module.